Just a friendly reminder for tomorrow, you have 11 through 20, and we're going to start our lecture. We have a ton of content this week. I know we started here in second period, but it's a ton of content. Hopefully I can add some content to the end of this, depending on how fast we go. Whatever we do not finish in class today is your responsibility to complete. Is everyone clear on that?
Yeah.
All right, so let's get to it so we don't have to do it for homework. All right, here we go. All right, Ibn Battuta, Moroccan jurist and traveler from his Rishla, or travel journal, travels in Asia and Africa, the oasis of Waltan in West Africa after crossing the Sahara in 1350 CE. All right, what do we know? Alex?
He's in West Africa.
Okay, he's in West Africa, so what do we know?
He's probably hanging with the
No, that's in South Asia.
Oh, sorry.
That's
sorry.
In India.
Sorry,
Ghana. All right, so he's going to be in West Africa, so they are newly open for what?
Trade.
Open for trade. Okay, and what are they now exposed to? What's new to them?
India.
What? India?
Muslims.
Muslims. Islam is new. Islam is new-ish. Okay, what do we know about Ibn Battuta? Is he famous or is he a random dude? He's a super famous traveler. Famous traveler. Okay? And he is a Muslim himself. All right, perfect. All right, here we go. My stay in, sure, lasted about 50 days, and I was shown honor and entertained by its inhabitants. It is an excessively hot place and boasts a few small date palms in the shade of which they sow watermelons. Its water comes from the ground. Actually, hold on. What are dates? Why would he note that there are dates? What do you got, Avery? Well, we eat them dried, but they don't come dried. They're little fruits, and where do they come from? No, they don't, actually. They're from the Middle East. They're super popular in the Middle East, okay? And they're known as a delicacy.
They're kind of gross.
They are kind of gross. It's not my taste either, but people love... They're, like, one of the most popular fruits in the world. Why is that weird? They make good jam, apparently.
They're okay.
They're okay. What do you got, Payne? Yes, so it's the connection because they clearly come from the Middle East. We know that they had to be traded there. They also sow watermelons. I thought watermelons was an American thing. I had no idea. Its water comes from underground waterbeds to that point, and there is plenty of mutton to be had. What is mutton?
It's like, oh.
Lamb.
Isn't it stomach?
No.
I've known
it sounds like lamb stomach. No. Yeah. The garments of its inhabitants, most of whom belong to Mustafa tribe, are one of fine Egyptian fabrics. If they're fine Egyptian fabrics, are they expensive or cheap?
Expensive.
They're expensive. So are they... Okay, is this positive or negative?
Positive.
Super positive, yeah, for sure. He seems pretty damn impressed. All right, their women are of surpassing beauty. Okay. And are shown more respect than men. Damn, that's unique. Can we agree? Oh, look at us throwing down some vocab. The state of affairs amongst these people is indeed extraordinary. Their men show no signs of jealousy, whatever. No one claims descent from their father, but on contrary from his mother's brother. That was not very clear, but that's fine. Okay, so what is this, Jesse?
Matrilineal.
And what does that mean, Jesse? There you go. Now, say the what famous religion does this as well? You pass down your religion through your mom.
Jewish.
Isn't? I don't think Hinduism. Judaism is. Yeah, Judaism is passed to the woman. A person's heirs are his sister's sons, not his own sons. This is a thing which I've seen nowhere in this world except among the Indians of Malabar. But those are heathens. These people are Muslims. Punctilious in observing the hours of prayer, studying the books of law, and memorizing the Quran. Yet their women show no bashfulness before men and do not veil themselves, though they are assiduous in ascending their other prayers. Any man who wishes to marry one of them may do so, but they do not travel with their husbands, and even if one desired to do so, her family would not allow her to do it. So, it's kind of weird, right? The first matrilineal society here we've studied. The women the women here have friends and companions amongst the men outside their own families, and the men in the same way have companions amongst the women of other families. A man may go into the house and find his wife entertaining her companion, but he takes no objection to it. One day, and sure, I went into Kwadi's house after asking his permission to enter and found him with a young woman of remarkable beauty. When I saw her, I was shocked and turned to go out, but she laughed at me instead of being overcome by shame, and then Kwadi said to me, "Why are you going out? She's my companion." I was amazed by their conduct, for he was a theologian and a pilgrim to Mecca to boot. I was told that he had asked the Sultan's permission to make the pilgrimage that year with his companion, whether this or this one or not, I cannot say, but the Sultan would not grant it. There you go. All right.
Wait, the companions are like the mistresses?
I don't think so. I think, so the friends would be our... I'm not sure if there's a sexual relationship with companions. I don't know. I don't know these people. These aren't people we study. So I don't know the connections. I'm not sure if it's a sexual relationship or what. I don't know. I would assume, since they're using two different words, that it would be of some sort of sexual relationship, but I can't explicitly tell you. All right, here we go. What is historical context? The faster we move, the less homework you have in addition. Avery. I'm sorry, what?
I don't know how to say his name.
It's fine. Do the best you can.
It's like traveling around.
Yeah. Uban Batua. He's traveling through West Africa. There you go. Who's the audience of the piece? Aiden. Yeah, so it's originally for him. It's a journal, so it's originally for him. Okay, what is the purpose of the piece? What is the purpose of the piece, Vance?
Is it to inform
both family? No, it's a little shallow. No, Vedula?
Is it to, like, track what he's discovered, like, in his pictures?
Kind of, Maggie. Yeah, showing the differences between cultures. Now keep in mind, he's originally from Morocco, which is on the northern tip of Africa, correct? Just below Spain. They're in West Africa, which would be in, like, if you look over here where they're talking about, they're going to be, like, right in this area. So is he far away from where he lives? Not really. I mean, he's also going to be all the way over here. And he's also going to be way over here. So if he is from Morocco, which is right here, and now he's down here, okay, is that really far from his home?
No.
No. However, is it worlds away from what he's used to?
Yes.
For sure. So what is the point of view of this piece, Alex? Okay, give a context to that surprise.
Like, how the woman are
they're allowed to hang out with other people. Oh my god, how scandalous.
No, they're not allowed to, but like, I mean, how the conduct, you know.
Okay, we're getting there, Ben.
They take, like, their, like, ancestry, I guess, from their mothers.
Okay, so, but what is his point of view? It's his point of view. What is his big component of it? Jesse? Yeah, is he pleasantly surprised or is he just horrified surprised? I think he's pleasantly surprised. I think. Well, if you, like, for instance, have you, Jesse, have you left the United States?
Yeah.
Have you ever gone to, like, any place in, like, the Caribbean? Okay, well, in the Caribbean, I remember I was, like, 10 or 11 years old. We got on a cruise, and we were in we were on the islands, like, St. Lucia and all that stuff, which is owned by countries over in Europe and stuff like that. And we got walked through, like, a bunch of bushes to get to the beach, and it was a nudist beach. I'm, like, 10 or 11 years old. And obviously, we were not planning on going to a nudist beach. My parents were horrified when we got to it. And it was a straight-up nudist beach, not, like, a topless beach. Everyone. And as soon as my dad saw what was happening, he just grabbed the children. and just turn. That is like a horrified, and we got right back in our little car, and we were like, what is happening? And my mom's like, those are things you shouldn't have to see this young. What the hell is happening? That would be like, that would be kind of the surprise kind of component of it. Does that make sense? Okay, what do you got, Shabani?
Oh, could it also be like the people there are Muslim, but they still don't like the women still don't like covering themselves up?
For sure. He was surprised by how pious. What does pious mean? A pious is like religious. Pious is like the fact that you follow your religion as closely. It's typically tied to Christians, but you can apply it to anyone. He was surprised by how pious the women were. Women were. And how, in quotes, free they were in their power. There we go. Okay. Why is it significant? Why do we care about it? Why did I pick this out of the thousands of Ibn Battuta ones I could have shown you? Why, Claire? Okay, why is it so special? I think all cultures, women. Let's not put it just in Islamic ones. We haven't seen any Christian multilineal either. Shows a matrilineal society that has embraced Islam. There we go. All right. This is going to be fun. Everyone loves a good poem. I don't know why. This is the first one I've ever used it. I really enjoyed it first period, Monday morning. It was awesome. It's going to go better right now, though, right, Sadie? Sadie loves poems, so she's going to guide us through. Here we go. Yogami Ohakura, Japanese governor of the province of Chukchi. Sure. What do we know? Do we know anything?
No.
It's in Japan. Okay, so it's in Japan. He's the governor, so he's the ruler-ish of the region. Okay, it's in the province of, which happens to be northern Japan. Okay, so this is the Nara government, which is your first government, which is only in what aspect, north or south?
North.
It's in the south. It's a province, so it's not officially a part of it. Does that make sense? It's a province. So, South Japan. All right. In the greatest days of old, when over the land the gods held sovereign sway, our fathers loved to say that the bright gods with tender care enfold the fortunes of Japan. Let's just stop right there. In the great days of old, so a long time ago, yes? We're there. When over the land the gods held sovereign sway. What is this saying? What is this saying, Isabella? The gods were in control.
Yeah.
Okay. Our fathers loved to say, I think we've got that one, yes? Okay.
Yeah.
That the bright gods with tender care enfold. Tender care enfold means they what?
Love you.
They give us. That the bright gods with tender care enfold the fortunes of Japan. What are the fortunes of Japan? Remember, this is 733, so they're giving oil. That was a very popular answer last period. There is no oil in the world. When oil came up, anytime they dug like a well or something, it ruined everything and they had to leave that land. Quite the opposite of how we feel today, correct? Okay, oil was a nuisance, not a positive thing. It is not oil. I have no idea where they pulled oil from, but they were hardcore about it. It's not oil. What are the fortunes of Japan, Macy?
Is it rice?
Is it rice? It's, can we be less stereotypical? There's other things that grow in Japan besides rice. They eat other things, actually, as well. What do you got, Jesse?
Like land is arable.
Okay. The fortunes of Japan, arable.
Arable land?
There are crops / food sources. Okay, so, in the great days of old, when over the lands that God held sovereign sway, our fathers loved to say that the bright gods with tender care enfold the fortunes of Japan. So, summarize this little thing. What is it trying to tell us? What do you got, Chloe? The gods gave us food. Yeah, there we go. All right. Blessing the land with many a holy spell. Blessing the land with many of a holy spell. And what they love to tell, we of this later age ourselves do prove, for every living man may feast his eyes on tokens of their love. Okay, so blessing the land with many of a holy spell. Okay, so what does that mean? Paint?
They blessed it.
Yeah, they blessed the land. They bless the land. They say, oh, grow food here. And then what pops up? And what they love to tell, these are the gods speaking. Oh, that's not how you spell gods. God speaking. We of this later age ourselves do prove. So these are people, these are later generations. For every living man may feast his eyes on tokens of their love. What are tokens of their love? What are the tokens, Avery? Plenty of what? Plenty of food. What else, Garrett? Food and bounty. Bounty is like anything that comes from the land. And so there are... What else do Japanese people eat besides rice? What do they put in their rice, typically? They roll it. Fish, seafood. They're also...
Or watermelon.
Do they have
rice? I don't know if that's an American crop or not. I'm not sure.
Are they different between, like, regular rice and soy? Oh, they, like, soak it in, like, a... They soak it. No, seriously.
Historical context, friends. We've got to finish this primary source. Or you're doing it for homework. I don't care. We can argue sticky rice or non-sticky rice. Doesn't matter to me. Maggie. That's a historical context? Historical context is like historical facts.
They believe in...
They're polytheists. Fans, help my girl out.
It's... I guess South Japan.
Yeah, this is the first government in Japan. Do you see the difference that I'm talking about there, Maggie? First government in Japan. Sanara. Okay, who's the audience of this piece, Sadie?
What?
Who is this piece written for? It's a poem, so who likes poems? Ring around the rosy, pocket full of posing.
Oh, they're teaching the kids about children.
Not teachers. This is awful. It is children. Children and the people of Japan. What is the purpose of this piece? Bendela. I've wanted to ask you this for about 10 weeks now. Do you like vindaloo?
What?
Do you like vindaloo? Do you eat Indian food?
No.
No.
Okay, so the purpose of this piece would probably be to, like, tell the kids about, or, like, children about, like, what the previous gods gave them, like, how they're so successful today.
So the purpose is to show power and abilities. The gods. All right, so why are we teaching this song about the power of gods? What's the point of view? What's the purpose of it? What's the point of view of the piece? What is the purpose of the piece, Natalie?
To show,
point of view.
To show, like, how much control the gods have over the evil people.
It's not terrible. It's not terrible. Keep in mind, this is created by a Japanese governor, and the province is the one who is writing this. Why would he be writing this? Okay, so to gain favor of the gods. To help them fall apart or help them rule?
To help them rule.
Of course. Well, we gotta explain that. Okay. To help maintain power. Because things, when people don't have food, do they revolt against the government?
Yes.
Yes. So, by showing that the gods smile on this government, look at all the food we have, it shows that it gives them more power. Why do we care about it? Why do we care? Jesse, we don't need to live your yawn, sweetie. Why do we care about it? Why did I choose to do a poem with you? Which you won't see many of these going forward. Katie?
It shows,
shows how governments manipulate religion and resources to show off their power. There you go. All right, perfect. Take out your notebook. I don't know how much longer we have, but we're going. All right, you can raise your hand and tell me where we left off.
Kingdom of Congo. Kingdom
of Congo, perfect. Ooh. All right, here we go.
Are there notes in the video?
Yes. Yeah, I've been recording you guys. All right, here we go. So the Kingdom of Congo, okay, is where we left off. We talked about cowrie shells, yes? Okay, the currency and all that stuff? Okay, all right, perfect. So, now, you probably don't need to write this down because we've talked about it, I feel like, 10,000 times. Islam is going to be the largest and most common religion spread along the Silk Road. So, as they're coming across Africa, what are they carrying with them?
Islam.
And as they pass through, what's being left behind? Islam. There you go. So, you shouldn't have to write that down. Okay, you do need to know that this trans-Saharan trade is going. It takes about 70 to 90 days. Okay, and you're going to have major trading capitals. Just be aware of it. You don't have to write everything down, but just be aware of it. Okay. All right, Kingdom of Ghana. Here we go. So the Kingdom of Ghana, this is all on the Trans-Saharan trade route, by the way. So the Kingdom of Ghana, okay, they are going to be major traders of gold. You need to know they are gold traders. Okay. They also do ivory and they do slaves, but mostly all their money is coming from is gold. They have a big problem with camel driving raiders. What are camel driving raiders? What do you think they are, people? Fancy.
Are they nomads?
They're kind of nomadic people, but mostly they're kind of like pirates but on land, and they ride camels.
Camel?
Yeah, they are. They're pretty fast.
That is so weird for me to think about.
Yeah.
Yeah. Camels?
It's just so like.
They can run. We can talk about the imagery of pirates on camels, or we can keep going.
I vote camels.
Now, I don't care about if you know that. So, Kingdom of Ghana is going to convert to Islam. Who can raise your hand and tell me why would a major trading destination convert to Islam? Shabani. There you go. They're going to create a genuine cultural connection, and that will hopefully foster more goods. Okay, and they are going to blend some of their culture with Islam. What's a fancy term we talk about when we take two different cultures and blend them, Garrett?
Assimilation.
No. Assimilation is you come to the United States and you only speak English and dress in an American. That'd be assimilation. Syncretism. Perfect. Okay, so they're gonna they're gonna use some syncretism and blend Islam with Africa. Alright. Sundita is going. Now, right Kingdom of Malai. Kingdom of Elijah, next one. Goodbye. At least we got something. Mostly, you've got the vision of pirates on camels. And that's all you really wanted anyway. Goodbye. Tomorrow you have 11 through 20. Goodbye.
I think we'll finish
offense. Is there more than last week?
Yeah, it's
yeah.
two chapters. Way to get your spice done this week there, boss. Did you do your spice?
Yeah, I did it over the weekend. I did my spice in
focus. Okay, good. You didn't notice it was two chapters?
No. Oh, yeah, I got that.
Am I ruining your life that bad? That's fine. Why don't you be here by 7:45?
Are you doing the thing on Wednesday again this week?
Yes.
Jesus, minute.
Take this pink ribbon off my eyes. I'm exposed, and it's no big surprise. Don't you think I know exactly where I stand? This world is forcing me to hold your hand.
So many reasons for me to